Greetings, cyber dogs. This is Randog coming at you from deep underground in this Let's Play Minecraft 1.4 survival series. In the previous episode, we started going on an adventure to find some freaking loot and some diamond and some creeper poo, and we almost freaking died. Oh my god, guys. At the end of the last episode, while I was saying goodbye to you guys, a creeper came from here. A creeper came from here at the same time and blew my ass up, and literally I flew up, smacked against this wall, landed right here on this little spot right here. Oh my god, guys, it was so freaking close to death. It is unbelievable. Now, when you guys told me hard mode was hard, man, I had no freaking idea how hard. I think I'm actually underestimating how difficult hard mode is. So I'm definitely going to be trying to play a little bit safer from now on out. I'm going to keep my eyes open for creepers, and I'm going to be destroying lava wherever I see it, guys, because lava is my freaking enemy right now in hard mode, man. Lava is what is going to be the freaking death of me. And if we lose Fang and Rambo in lava, oh my god, I'm going to be one sad little doggy, man. I don't know what I'm going to do, man. I don't know if I can recover from that. Oh my goodness. So guys, we need to get some water, man. That is what we need to get. We need to get water before we do anything else. I thought I heard a little bit of water from around here somewhere. Ooh, looks like a little bit of light up in there. Okay, so up there is obviously where we've been already. Oh my god, I'm freaking out now. Any sound is making me jump. And that freaking sizzling sound, man, that is the sound that I do not want to be hearing. So I'm going to come up here. I'm going to try to find some water. Guys, thank you so much for all your freaking comments in the previous episode, man. Oh, it was a crazy episode. I can't believe that I didn't die, actually. It's quite unbelievable that I didn't fall into that lava. But thanks to everybody who gave me some hints and tips about how to survive in hard mode, guys. And a lot of you guys have told me that water is very, very, very important for hard mode. So I'm going to get myself some water. I thought I saw a little bit up here. Yes, water. Oh, get in my bucket. Get in my bucket. Oh, God. That feels so good. There's a creeper. And oh god, thank you, Fang, for being so freaking powerful. I love your ass, man. Seriously, without Fang, guys, we would have been dead long ago, because we wouldn't have been able to kill the creepers fast enough. Right, so guys, my goal at the moment is to get dynamite, aka creeper poo, and to get diamonds. Dynamite and creeper poo. Whew, at the same time. So that is what we're doing in this episode today, guys. Hopefully we'll be able to find quite a lot of creeper poo. Thank you for mentioning, guys, that you guys saw some dynamite in the Lakeside Villa chest. That's excellent. I didn't even spot that. So thanks for spotting that for me, guys. On our way back to the mole hole after this adventure, we're going to pick up that dynamite. And man, we're going to be blowing up the ass of the Nether Portal Temple Foundations. That is the ultimate goal, guys, because we want to get our asses to the Nether. Now, I want to talk a little bit about the Nether in this episode. What quite a few of you are saying is that maybe what I should do is go to the Nether first, and that way I can actually collect some of the Nether bricks that I could use to then build the Nether Portal Temple. And I think that's actually a sweet idea. Come, you want to rumble, bastard? Give me your bones! I actually think that's a really sweet idea. There's a bit of dynamite over there, actually. And I think that's maybe what I'll do, actually, is go to the Nether before completing the temple so that we can use some of the sweet-ass bricks that we can find in the Nether to build the temple. I'm also going to be using black wool to use the temple. And guys, one of you gave me such an amazing suggestion for the Nether Portal temple design. I'm going to run it past you guys, man. Oh, you want to go? You want to rumble, man? Take it! Freaking butt. Oh my god. Is there a creeper spawn around here? I mean, a mob spawn around here. Sounds like it, doesn't it? Oops. Okay, it is on. Fang! Unleash! So guys, one of you gave me such an amazing idea for the Nether Portal Temple. You said, why not make the floor of the Nether Portal Temple glass, and underneath the glass make lava? There's some gold for Granny Dog. Sweet. And I think that is a great idea, man. I think I'm definitely going to be doing that. We're going to definitely be, you know, making some sort of lava floor, I think, with glass on top of it. That is so sweet, man. That is so nether portal temple-y. So I'm going to be doing that, man. So thanks for that, man, whoever gave me that suggestion. That was sweet. Oh my god, guys. Oh my god, we just... Look at this. It is a dungeon. We just dug into a... This is so awesome. Okay, people, this time around, we're going to do this properly, man. We are not going to die like freaking noobs. Or we're not going to let a creeper destroy our dungeon. That is the most important thing, man. We're not going to let a creeper destroy our dungeon. Oh my god. Oh my god, guys. Need to eat an apple. Need to eat an apple. This is not going well. Okay, okay, okay. Time to employ drastic action, man. Let us freaking lock ourselves in here. Oh my god, guys. Hard mode is seriously, it is actually giving me an aneurysm. I can feel my heart slowly stopping to function. Even if that was an English sentence, I'm not sure. And nor was that. But basically, you see what's happening to me, man. Hard mode is taking its toll on my ass. But I am determined to get better at hard mode, guys. This is amazing. Okay, let's do this properly, people. I know I said that last time, and it resulted in us having our freaking dungeon completely annihilated. But this time around, we're not taking any chances, man. This is epic. Now, where is this? Let's just press X. Let's see where we are. Okay, we're just, like, sort of behind the Lakeside Villa. There you can see the quarry where I dig out my sand. And then all the way to the left there, you can see the Lakeside Villa. So we're actually pretty close. Okay, guys. I don't even know what a creeper sounds like, but... Alright, there is the spawner in there, right? There are the zombies. Is it a zombie spawner? Because if it is, then this is going to be our potato and carrot farm. And it is going to be sweet. Okay. Let's kill these guys as fast as we possibly can. Burn! Burn, you bastard! Alright. I can't see any creepers, but I'm gonna take this so slow, guys. Seriously. If we lose another zombie spawner, I'm just gonna be so sad. I'm gonna jump into the tanks, basically. Right. Any creepers? No. Let's secure the spawner. I'm gonna secure the spawner right now. Oh yes, baby. Oh yes, there we go. This is like a mini one, man. Check how small it is. It's so sweet. Alright, spawner secured, people. Let's open the chest. What do we got in here? Oh, a whole bunch of gunpowder. We definitely need that. And another bucket. That will do very nicely, thank you. Oh my god, guys, this has been epic, man. We almost freaking died in the last episode, but look what has happened, man. The results. Oh god, this is excellent. Right, so I think I need to head back up just to make sure that we know where the spawner is. Let's just completely wall it off. I want to harvest the cobblestone, the mossy cobblestone. I know this isn't quite what we're supposed to be doing, guys, but you know. It's a freaking mob spawner, man. And it's a zombie mob spawner, guys. Do you guys even realize how sweet this is, man? Let's just take... Oh, God! He's like, dude! Leave my friends alone! Sorry, dude. I've trapped your friends forever, man. They're gonna be forever harvested. Oh, God, I lost those. That's okay. I'm not willing to take the risk of a creeper getting his ass in here, man. I'm gonna block everything off. There we go. Guys, this means we can make an infinite supply of carrots and potatoes. And in 1.4.4, we need carrots to breed... I think we need carrots to breed pigs, I believe. And we need potatoes to breed something else. I think both of those are actually very important materials. Oh my god, let me quickly harvest this, guys, and then block off the mob spawner again. We need those materials desperately, so this is an incredible find for us. I'm just getting really nervous that there's going to be creepers around here, so let's quickly wall everything off where we can. Let's get some torches up in here. Make sure this is a spawn-free zone. Okay, excellent, excellent. Okay, I feel that we have attacked this mob spawner in a much better way than we did last time around. I feel like we secured it really, really well, really, really quickly. We didn't take any dramatic risks. What? Where did you spawn? Alright, let's get some more torches in here, man. Torches everywhere. Everywhere. We secured it in a really quick and timely fashion. And I think that was really well done, actually. And I know it's not looking great, all of this cobblestone everywhere. But guys, I am not freaking risking losing this mob spawner again. Oh man, happy days! I'm so freaking happy, man. Now, near the lakeside villa, we have a spider spawner and a zombie spawner. Very, very close to the lakeside villa. So that means that the lakeside villa has just become even more important to us, guys. The lakeside villa has basically gone from being a little holiday home to being an actual resource magnet for us, man. Okay, so we're totally walled off here. Excellent. Now I can just open this space up a bit and expose the zombie spawner for what it is. You've been exposed. Oh my god, almost. Okay, don't put pickaxe near zombie spawner. That is not good. Okay, excellent, excellent, excellent. Oh man, you guys can moan all you want, man. You are not getting out of your eternal prison. You are going to be trapped in my freaking Minecraft world for eternity. You're going to be making me delicious potatoes and carrots forever. Oh goodness, this is so sweet, guys. Oh god. No, 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 no! Back up, back up! Is there another one in there? What the hell? I did this, right? Just to make sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did this. Let's just make sure. Let's just put a little peeky hole through there. Because these could be walls of other spawners. But that doesn't look like it. Okay, excellent, guys. Oh my god, I'm so happy. This is so awesome, man. But the one thing is, we are getting slightly distracted from our task of getting to the nether. But I mean, you know, that is Minecraft for you, man. You never know what is around the next corner. Like, a lot of people who, a lot of my friends, actually, who've watched my series or just watched, like, a couple of episodes, they always ask me, like, why do you like Minecraft so much? Don't you just run around collecting resources and don't do anything? And yes, that is true. You do spend a lot of time collecting resources. But guys, look at what happens, man. At every turn, something new happens. And that is what makes Minecraft so amazing. For me, anyway, is that there's always something new going on. And even though we do have a goal, guys, and oh, I can hear some of you shouting at me, man. Eat! Eat, you bastard, is what you're saying. So, there we go. We've eaten. Let's get our asses up to land, right? So we need to head in a westerly direction and upwards. And I'm going to make a little staircase all the way up to land over there. And we'll see how far we are away from the lakeside villa. And we're not going to make the mob spawner now, but we're definitely going to be making the mob spawner right after we make the nether portal temple. Oh god, this is so awesome, guys. All right, so Season 2, man, what is our initial goal? So our first goal is to get to the nether. That is goal numero uno. Goal numero dos is going to be to make a spider spawner and a zombie spawner. Because, you know, when we get to the nether, right, we're going to be able to start making potions. And we need spider eyeballs to make potions, to make some of the potions. So that's what our spider spawner is going to give us. And we need, for the new 1.4 animal breeding program, we need potatoes and carrots. And that is what our zombie spawner is going to give us. So basically, this episode, I think this is episode 8, has literally just solidified the first, the goals for, the first 25 episodes of Let's Play Minecraft Season 2. And that is so sweet, man. We have such epic freaking goals to get working on, guys. Oh my goodness, this is so sweet. And that isn't even considering one of the goals of building an underground railway network through the giant ravine, so the Booty Ravine, which is the ravine we're in right now, all the way to the second continent. Man, that was close. No! No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Water, not good. Water bad. Water very bad. If water destroyed zombie spawner, I will be a sad panda. Wow, it came close. and And I made that exact same mistake the last time we found a zombie spawner, guys. So I don't seem to be learning from my mistakes. But any hoozle, hopefully we'll learn this time. Okay, so we're coming up into the ocean, right? So let's just make a little... Let's just make a water block over here. And we're just going to have to go for it. I think what we'll do is swim. Swim? Oh my god. That is too much swimming. Alright, we've got a water block in here right now. How do we get up without dying? Because this is actually really, really far. I think what we're going to have to do actually is dig a little bit more in this direction. Let's just open up the passageway down to the zombie spawner again. I think we're going to have to dig a little bit in this direction and then go upwards. The problem is the sand is... Alright, so let's do it like this, right? I'm going to break this and put... Ooh, no, that wasn't good. Luckily, I made another water break down there. Right, so have I actually... I blocked the water off here, right? Okay, excellent. So we're just going to head in this direction until we get underneath the solid ground, and then we'll head back up again. You know, just let's play this safe, man. Let us not risk anything, because this is the first zombie spawner that we found that is relatively close to the lakeside villa. You know, so we definitely can't avoid losing this. The only other zombie spawner that we found was at the NPC village, you know, and that's all the way at the end of the Great Railway Network. So that's probably not exactly where we want to be. So let's start heading up, guys. Let's get to the freaking surface. And then once we've broken the surface, we can continue on our adventure in the giant ravine. Because I think we need a little bit more gunpowder. We got 10 gunpowder from this episode so far. Not enough to do the massive amounts of explosions that we want to be doing for the Nether Portal Temple Foundations. Hello. Have we just broken into... Mushrooms? Oh, we found another freaking dungeon. Oh my goodness, we're going to be able to make like dual... Oh, is it... Okay, that was... Oh, okay, these aren't the dangerous spiders. Thank the Lord. We just found another dungeon, guys. With a whole bunch more gunpowder too, which is awesome. Oh man, this has been like the most epic freaking adventure ever, dudes. Seriously, man, this has been like the most lucrative freaking mission we've been on in a long ass time. We found another freaking spawner here. Another spider spawner. Oh my goodness, guys, I cannot believe this, man. This is so sweet. Right, let's pick these up. So this has got to be pretty relatively close to... Man, we got mushrooms here also. Sweet. This has got to be pretty close to our other spider spawner, right? So maybe what we could do is connect the spider spawners together. Let's just make sure nothing is spawning around here. We could make like a dual pronged spider spawner, but I have a feeling that this spider spawner might be a little bit too far away from the other spider spawner. I'm not 100% sure how close they need to be, because you need to be near the spider spawner to make it spawn, right? I think you need to be 128 blocks away. So if we can find a sweet spot in between this spider spawner and the other spider spawner, then we can get them both spawning at the same time when we're chilling in the sweet spot, right? So that's pretty sweet. What can we get rid of in here, man? We don't need any more cobblestone. We have cases, we have chests full of cobblestone from the Nether Portal Temple, man. Okay, excellent, man. This is so awesome. I am so freaking happy right now, guys. This has been one of the most lucrative adventures ever in both seasons. And it sounds like it might not even be over. If there is another zombie spawner here, that would just be that would be intense, man. That would actually be too much for me to take. I think I would just pop. Well, let's take a quick look, shall we? Burn, you bastard! What do we got in here, man? Whoa! Ooh, damn! Alright, let's eat, man. Okay, so this is just opening up into more cavern. Which is... Ooh, Bat, you just... Man, you scared the living daylights out of me, Batty. Okay, so there's absolutely nothing down here of much interest. Back to our spider spawner. Okay. Whoa! Did he spawn from the spawner? I think so. Alright, let's cover this bad boy in torches. Wait, that's an apple. Apples don't make freaking light. Let's collect all our mossy cobblestone, man. It's my favorite texture in Minecraft. I love mossy cobblestone. It is so sweet. Alright, guys, so we have found... Okay, let's just make sure that we know... Where is our adventure shaft, actually? It's this way, right? Okay, so it's this way. Okay, so spider spawner that way. And up to the surface this way. So let's just continue on our dig upwards. I would say mission accomplished for this episode. Man, it has been sweet. I can't believe we found a spider spawner and a zombie spawner so close to each other. I think we're going to have to try and link them up, right? Somehow. And I mean, the only way to do it is to use water canals to push the mobs all together into one chute, and then maybe using signs in a water canal to pull the mobs upwards to a processing facility on the surface. Now we're talking, guys. A mob spawner processing facility. That is sounding sweet, man. So it's kind of like the strip mine outpost, except it's actually going to do something. It's actually going to have value. no offense, strip mine outpost. I love you, man. But man, your asymmetry, it hurts my soul, man. Your asymmetry makes me sad. Right. So we got to be breaching the surface pretty soon, right? I mean, goodness. I mean, how high up is this? You see, the mob spawner processing facility might have to be underground because it looks like we're actually really deep. Both of those dungeons are actually really, really deep. So, you know, it's going to have to be an underground facility, I think. Which is sweet. I mean, I'm down with that. I'm down with underground facility. It means we get to use more dynamite, right? And, I mean, maybe this time we can actually do it properly and blow up squares. You know, we could try and line up the dynamite so that it blows up squares and makes like proper rooms, and then we can make like kind of like the Rengox laboratory, right, from the Tekkit series, but underground. Man, that'd be sweet. Alright, so here we are, guys, on the surface. It looks like it's nighttime. Let's get a bit of light up in here. Sounds like there's hostiles. Yep, there's hostiles. Engaged. Alright, guys, so here, this is basically a shaft to happiness. This is like the happy shaft, right? and I think what we need to do is make some sort of a path, right? So why don't we quickly dig out like a road so we know exactly how to get here. Just light that bad boy up, right? So then we'll see it quite clearly on the map. So this is actually going to connect quite nicely to the sandstone quarry, it looks like. Man, do you hear all those zombies, guys? That seriously sounds like another spawner is around here. Seriously, man, that sounds like another zombie spawner. If you can believe it, man. You better believe it, because I think it's true. Sweet, guys. Well, there we go, man. Now we know how to get to our spawners. And I'm sure there's another zombie spawner down there, so I'm definitely going to be checking that out in the next episode, guys. But I'm going to have to end the episode here, I'm afraid. We've run out of time. But, man, it has been freaking sweet. Oh, I don't have an axe. I'm going to have to use my pickaxe, I'm afraid. But, guys, if you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed playing it, hit that freaking like button, guys. And remember, if you haven't subscribed yet, now's the freaking time to subscribe because things just got interesting. Man, we just found an epic, epic, epic tunnel of love, basically. Of Minecraft love, that is. There's two zombie spawners down. Whoa. Down there. And it sounds like there might be another zombie spawner very close to the surface. So in the next episode, guys, if a creeper doesn't blow up my ass, I'm going to be trying to find the zombie spawner right under here. Thank you so much for watching, guys. It's been Rendog playing Minecraft Survival. We'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.